Hey everyone, it's Morgan Yates, and I'm super excited for today's video. I did this video last year sharing kind of basically just the same thing, like 7 things I do every single day to stay happy and healthy. And from that point last year to now, my life has changed a lot. You know, I was a single gal back then, living with roommates. I've moved since then. Like, I just feel like my life is so different. And I feel like now my like top 7, I don't know, biggest, most important things that I see that I do every single day are a little bit different now. So I just wanted to recreate this video. I'm gonna be going through these 7 points chronologically, based on when they come up throughout my day, and share some new things I've learned, some new things that are working for me, and maybe this will help some of you guys out. I also think we may have finally found a background setup. Let me know what you think. Also, before we get to into this video, I want to thank Evernote for sponsoring it. I'll be sharing a little bit more about them later, but hopping in to point number 1, the first thing I do, or that I guess I have every single day, is a morning routine. For me, I'm not really, well, I wake up early, but I don't wake up energized in the morning. You know what I mean? If it were up to me, like what I feel like doing and want to do every morning is like scroll through TikTok on my phone, laying in bed for like, I don't know, the better part of an hour, you know, take it easy. On the weekdays, for me to actually like get up and at them in the morning, it is crucial that I have my like morning routine tasks that I can just get straight out of bed and like mindlessly roll into. So for me, these are so simple. It's like getting up, making my bed, going into my bathroom and washing my face, brushing my teeth, putting on deodorant and brushing my hair. After that, I come downstairs, I drink my greens, I'll make my coffee, and I will eat avocado toast for breakfast. Just like first thing when I wake up, that is what I eat like every single day for breakfast. Again, it's just like taking any thought out of my morning when I am tired, and that's it. Like, those are my like quick and easy morning tasks. It's really the bare minimum. Running through those tasks has become such a habit to me that like I just, the second I wake up, can just like roll into that, and there's no decision making involved, which is especially great for those mornings where maybe I'm feeling a little more tired and like I would just want to kind of like lag and lay around. Having just a handful of tasks to kind of roll through and get my momentum going for the day, to me, is just key to getting me like, you know, setting things in motion for the day. The second thing I do every day is I get ready for the day. The degree to which I get ready varies. If you work from home, then you may understand the dilemma here of, you know, you have the freedom to wake up in the morning, and in my case, I can just wear my big t-shirt I slept in the night before. I could wear that all day if I wanted to. I don't even have roommates anymore, so like really there's no one to impress. And for a while I was loving that. And if you're someone that can actually like be productive and have a normal day, like literally while just rolling out of bed, then I applaud you for that and I see no problem with it. However, for me, something I've started doing that has really helped to separate like my morning sleeping lazy time, or even like the weekends, I'll just stay in my t-shirt if I want to. But on weekdays, actually changing clothes out of that like comfy t-shirt, still into something comfy, putting on like a cute matching sweatsuit or like a tank top and sweatpants, changing clothes and like throwing my hair up or doing something to make it look a little bit more tame. Occasionally I'll put on makeup if I'm feeling like I really want to go next level with this. Really helps me to like separate that next part of my day and like feel a little bit more put together. I feel like it signals to my brain that we are now in like a different productive stage of the day. When I do that, I feel less like I want to just like lay around on the couch or something. Basically, I just feel more productive. Number 3 on this list is that I stay meticulously organized when it comes to work. I am out here making list after list after list. I've always been such a list maker. Something about the satisfaction of checking things off, I just love. I was previously making just a bunch of like individual documents and spreadsheets and things like that, and kind of all of my information was just spread out everywhere. And something I've recently started using that has made a big difference in my organization is using Evernote to have everything in one place. So if you're not familiar with Evernote, they're a note-taking app and website. I actually prefer the desktop version just because I'm usually working on my laptop, but it's really nice to be able to have access to all of my stuff on the app as well for when I'm on the go and need to reference that. Basically, I have a notebook for each month, and within that notebook I have a note for everything going on. So everything work related, I have one for like my miscellaneous tasks like my laundry and returns and phone calls, all the boring tasks. I have notes for everything I'm filming and creating. I have notes that are lists of content ideas, any kind of event I'm hosting, I have a note for. And what I love and find especially fun is that you can either just write out regular notes, or you can actually turn those into tasks. So when you're doing that, you can check them off and it'll say like you've checked off 4 of 6 things or whatever. It's just very like gratifying. Checking that off keeps me motivated and like continuing to work. Also, you can set due dates. So I'll set those when it comes to anything content related, especially if it's a due date for a brand partnership. And having all of that in Evernote is really nice, so that when I log in on my homepage, it shows my tasks at a glance for that day. The homepage in general is just really great. You can pin certain important notes. They have a little scratch pad area where you can write down anything right there. You can also tag your notes with different keywords. If maybe you have like notes on notes, that way anything you're looking for is really easy to find when you just search that keyword. And I really love that even my calendar is synced within Evernote. So right there on that same page, I can see like any of my social plans coming up, my workout classes I booked, any calls I have scheduled. Again, just like everything all at a glance right there. And overall, if you're someone who loves organization or if you're just like trying to stay more on top of things, Evernote has everything you could possibly ever need all in one place. You can even save like articles and web pages you want to reference, or you can save any kind of images or audio recordings and keep your flight like boarding passes on there. Something I'm gonna do for like my trips I have coming up is have like a note for each trip with like all my info and links and boarding passes and like everything linked all in one note. And I truly just love Evernote so much. So I am a huge list nerd. So I actually have a lot of fun using Evernote, just like mapping everything out. And I will have them linked below if you guys wanna check them out. Again, they just took organization and productivity to the next level for me. And just in general, over time, I feel like getting a grasp on how much I'm capable of accomplishing in one day has allowed me to be able to create really realistic to-do lists and kind of stay on top of my schedule that way. Moving on to number four, something I make sure to get in some capacity every single day is some form of movement. So this is twofold for me. Like, yes, there's the working outside of things, but also in general, again, since I do work from home, I am so stationary throughout the day that I try to get in little just like movement breaks. So something I've been making a point to do lately is go on like short little walk breaks. So in the morning, if I don't have a work task that I need to like immediately jump into, I'll try to go outside and go on a short like 15 minute walk. Later in the day, around like 1 or 2, I feel like I hit a big energy slump. So that's also a good time for me to just like get outside for a few minutes. I feel like it's a combination of like the fresh air and the movement, getting my blood flowing. I feel like it makes a difference in my mood and also ultimately in my productivity as well. I feel like coming back and being refocused after looking at something that wasn't a screen for a little bit of time can be just really helpful for breaking up my day. And then in addition to those little mini movement breaks, I also work out probably 5 to 6 days a week. If you follow the vlogs, then you know I've been talking about this, but we had a good stretch there where working out was not at the top of my priority list like it used to be, and it had become something that I kind of only did if there was time at the end of the day and if I had energy at the end of the day, and that was the real kicker. So a shift I've made recently that has seriously made the biggest difference for my mood and just for my, I don't know, my sanity even, and like me being an enjoyable, patient, like calm person to be around, is prioritizing a solid workout every single day as like my top priority. So for me, this is always either boxing or doing a Copilot app workout at home, or like on the weekends, I like going on hikes, but also just in general, been trying to get more steps lately. So personally, I just set a goal of like 10,000 a day, the common goal, I feel like. So if I have not hit that in a day with like my other walks, then in the evening, I'm watching a show, I'll just walk on the treadmill on an incline for a little bit. And going back to how I used to be, which is prioritizing that workout every single day and like knowing that that's something that's going to happen. I've only been back on this for a few weeks and I feel like I'm so much happier and so much calmer. And we all know this, exercise is good for your body. It's also so good for your mind. So that is something I am sure to get in every day. Next up, another thing we've been talking about in the vlogs lately, and that is getting quality alone time. This used to be so natural for me. I feel like to the point that I mean, I took it for granted. I didn't even like understand how much good quality alone time I was getting for like years and years. And again, in the past few weeks, this was another realization I had that I have not been getting that quality alone time that I used to. My alone time was mostly just working or working out or like, you know, cleaning, like doing those to do, like anything productive basically was my alone time. Because in the past, that like restful, good time to myself was often on the nights and weekends, which is now the time that me and my girlfriend have to spend together, as well as that's mostly when I see my friends. So those times don't work for me anymore. It only makes sense that I still need to carve out that like restful time for myself, especially as someone who is like borderline on the introvert side. I'm like kind of in the middle. So recently that's what I've been doing. I've been carving out on weekdays, like during the days, time where I allow myself to like not have that pressure of feeling like I need to be doing something productive, which if I'm alone again, it's just kind of how I've always been thinking for the past year or so. So at different points throughout the week on weekdays, I've been letting myself either like take a break and watch a show or like draw something or, you know, go get my nails done or do something, just basically anything that sounds fun to me and that would be restful and restorative. That again has made such a difference to like my mood and my overall just like peace and my own energy. Like I feel like when I take that alone time, I can then like go back into my relationships feeling like my, you know, my tank is full again. Number six, I talked about this one in my video last year, but I think this is still just like so important that I do every single day, is I do affirmations. That's in quotes because I don't just say them out loud. For me, it's something I've been doing for a couple years now that I absolutely love is having affirmations in my phone that go off as alarms. So it's just like changing the text for any kind of alarm in the clock app on your phone. So I have these that go off at 9:30, 12:30, 3:30, and 6:30 every single day. And each one is just a sentence of something that I'm just wanting to change my mindset about. So for example, one of mine every day says, I will not feel guilty for making choices that are in my best interest. And that's kind of in the context of I've just been saying no to a lot more plans recently, just because I'm not really always in the mood to just go out and drink I don't know. I'm wanting to be doing other things with my time. So that affirmation is in my phone so that I like can feel confident about those decisions. I have an alarm that goes off at 3:30 every day that says something about like, movement is good for my body. I'm fortunate to have a strong and healthy body. And that one goes off then because that's around the time that I would be getting in my like big workout of the day. So I would recommend if you're going to implement these little affirmations, trying to think of relevant times to pair them at through the day. And as someone who's been doing these for a couple years now, like this works, like it is so interesting and cool to be able to see like every affirmation that I implement is because I need to change my mindset about that thing. And over the course of like, I would say 2 or 3 months, like it just feels so natural to me. So then I like change the affirmation to something else. This is proven. I highly recommend doing this. If there's really any area in your life that you want to change your thinking about, maybe you need a little more self-love, put a little affirmation in there that's saying things you're good at. Like you could say, I am creative, hardworking, and doing the best I can. I am proud of all I've accomplished. Or like maybe there's an area you're struggling in, you can say like, I am becoming a better blank, I am making choices that I will see results from. And a really key one for me that goes off every day at 6:30, so it wasn't like wrapping up the day. This one I never change, and it says, I used to dream of this life. I feel like that is so true. Like so many of the things I always used to like wish for and pray for, I now have. Just that going off every day makes me like stop and have that moment of gratitude, even if it's really quick, and I just love that. And number 7, something I do or really try to do every single day is end the day with a clean space. So this is something that since not having roommates, I feel like has been a little bit more challenging. Again, if I am tired at the end of the day, I don't really have as much motivation to want to clean my space because it's not like my mess is in like a roommate space, you know what I mean? Like it used to be. However, I know what a huge difference it makes to wake up and like come downstairs to a clean space in the morning or a messy space. If it's clean, I can just like roll straight into my day. And if it's messy, to me, it's such an obstacle of like, well, then I have to get the motivation to clean it up because that wasn't part of my morning routine. And it's just like another mindset hurdle to jump over that I feel like slows down my day. It's just a mentality thing for me, kind of. I mean, I think everything on this list is in some way something I do to try to shift my mindset to a better place. So cleaning up my space every night so that I can have a fresh start in the morning is something that I try to do every single day. That brings me to the end of my list. Again, I would love to hear from you guys, things that you do every day that you feel like really improve your life. Again, I will have Evernote linked below. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm gonna have a travel vlog coming up really soon, so I'm very excited about that. And that is it. I will see all of you guys in my next video.